of the study was to investigate the physiological responses and performance responses in elite athletes during and after Levi Trenlow training camps into hypoxic condition, which are the simulated and real altitudes. So the use of altitude training is more and more common, and over 15 years of research have revealed that the Levi Trenlow method is very effective. Moreover, physiological differences between the real and simulated altitude have recently been found, and so the influence of the type of hypoxia used with these altitude camps is a very important question for the endurance sport community. So it was a crossover study design conducted over 2 years with a total duration of 33 weeks for each phase. We had first a 24 weeks period of training loads quantification, and then the training loads were supervised during a leading period of 3 weeks, the Levi Trenlow training camp of 18 days, and a lead-out period of 3 weeks. The leading part took place at an altitude of 2,250 meters under simulated or real altitude, and the training parts took place at an altitude between 1,100 and 1,200 meters. The subjects were elite triathletes training in the same club and under the supervision of the same coach. They made different pre and post tests before and after the training camps, and also a 5 3-kilometer running test near the sea level. In addition, the breathing frequencies and the nocturnal oxygen saturation was recorded every night during the world camps. This study confirmed that real and simulated altitude are definitely not interchangeable when several physiological responses are considered. However, the differences are not strong enough to induce a performance difference. The 3 kilometer running time was significantly faster 21 days after the Levi Trenlow camps, but no difference was found between the two hypoxic conditions at any time. Each hypoxic condition has advantages and drawbacks from a practical point of view. The real altitude condition leads to longer hypoxic doses for a given training period, which may fit easier in a complex training plan with elite athletes. But the logistical constraint and the cost may be detrimental. In contrast, the simulated altitude condition allows athletes to individualize the hypoxic stimulus. It may be interesting for athletes and trainers to adjust the hypoxic doses by modifying the time spent in the hypoxic rooms or the altitude level, depending of the athlete's training level and the athlete's physiological responses. However, training camps conducted under simulated altitudes require longer periods to achieve sufficient hypoxic dose because of the lower time spent in the hypoxia with the simulated altitudes compared to the real altitudes.